all in.
Nerdy dude stuff.
For those of you keeping track at home, today's beer of the day is brought to you by Blue Point Brewing Company, the Imperial Sunshine, brewed out of Portsmouth, New Hampshire. Ignore the fact that the Buffalo area code is on the glass. This is indeed from NH. This is a juicy blonde ale with orange and natural flavoring, 9.6 alcohol by volume, and it's truly delicious with that orange, zesty, juicy flavoring, and does not have any of that additional alcohol burn from when a beer has 9.6 alcohol in it. Overall, this is about an 8.5 out of 10, and I enjoy it. Cheers to you guys.
What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another video about helium mining and all that good stuff. If this is your first time on the channel, please take a moment to consider hitting that subscribe button and turning on the bell notification as we post videos weekly and we do a stream about helium mining and placement every Monday. And definitely also please take a moment to consider hitting that like button. Before we get into today's video, I do want to say I am looking a little fuzzy. I'm really bad at growing facial hair, but every November I do No Shave November in honor of testicular cancer awareness. So that's why I'm going to be a little greasy, a little funky, a little gross. It's not my normal look, so don't worry. And if you want to make fun of me, that's totally fine. I just can't grow facial hair. Now, the other day we did a rant video about why it kind of sucks to get into helium mining. That video was was based off of the up and downs of the helium mining network, and it's also the up and downs I've been experiencing with the Bobcat miners. There are also other miners do experience these issues, but we know that Bobcat is bad when it comes to OTAs and getting everything updated. Today's video is going to be a little bit more of a technical analysis reason why helium mining is a little funky, and maybe it's something you want to consider before you get into it. And we're going to look at some stuff on the screen here, and it was something that I didn't think I was going to be personally affected by, and I guess you could tell by the intro that we are affected by it. So with that said, we're going to jump into looking at the screen in our area, what challenges we are now facing on an actual challenge basis and not just an opinion piece, and how we could potentially or not even overcome it, and why I also think it might also assist the network and the project continue in the long term. All right, so let's take a look at the screen and let's get going. Of course, we're gonna start out with the price of helium. It's currently sitting at $46.04. I do believe that this is going to continue going up, so it's really important that I continue to hold and keep earning helium and just hang on to that until we see this price up in like the triple digits. Or they're gonna come out with the HIP-39 and it's going to completely switch all these numbers around, but at the end of the day, 1,000 helium will be worth 46.05 if that were to happen this morning, or so on and so forth. Now let's talk about, again, my setup that we have is going to be two Bobcats. We've got two Bobcat 300 miners. We have one here at my house with a 5.8 dBi fiberglass antenna, 8 meters up inside my attic with a LMR 400 cable. And then we have the miner over at my in-law's house that is external with a lightning arrestor with the antenna straight up in the air, and that's running off of this same antenna as well. So that is our setup. We go to our two miners here and we take a quick look. We do know that the network took a huge crap for the past couple of days, and we finally started firing back off yesterday and mining with it returning, and we started mining with 1.5, and then as of right now we're at 0.69 for the last 24 hours. So you can see right here we're at 0.69. we're just going to round that up, and we now have 6.22 in our account when the other day we had 4. Now, I talk about my spots because it's very, very interesting to see the area that we are in. When we first started mining, we were the only two in the area, with this guy down somewhere over here that only had two miners. And we both started at the same time. We've never witnessed or connected with them or anything because of their setup, but this was my miner right now, which you can see in the 30-day time frame, it's got 10.46. And then this is my miner right now. Now, this is also very weird because earlier, I think when I took a screen grab, this was at a 0.56 transmit scale, and now it's at a 0.63. So I don't really know why the scale is going up, but this is why I'm doing today's video, because this is actually something that there is a problem. I was the original two miners in this area with good setups, getting pinging back and forth, you know, making sure we're earning helium. It was nice that other miners were popping up around us, but all these miners are popping up way too freaking close. And the way we could tell and the way that's affecting our transmit scale and what kind of drives me nuts is that I was the original Mac Daddy here. I shouldn't be the one that's affected. Everyone else should be. And we'll discuss in a moment why that's not exactly beneficial to the actual project and the blockchain and the mining and the distribution that they're giving out to everyone. This isn't necessarily a bad thing that I would say, you know, steer you away from going into helium mining. This is just something that's frustrating to me. But you can use this really nifty tool, Hotspotty, which I've never pulled up in a video. I've only done it on streams because we look at other people's transmit scales. And this is a really, really useful tool to have and to know and to decide where you want to put your helium miners. So on Hotspotty right now, and you can you see? Yeah, you could see. Okay, so on Hotspotty right now, the area that I currently have my one miner in says they want, the whole goal of helium mining is proof of coverage, right? So they want to have all this coverage and they want it spread out everywhere. That's why they don't want people putting miners within 350 meters of each other in the same area, in the same network, because those miners, if they're providing double coverage, they're not providing the coverage wider in what Helium is hoping to accomplish. So they set up on Hotspotty and they set up these little grids on how your transmit scale will be affected. So when we first started, we were the only one on screen in this idiotic looking stop sign. I don't know. Let's say it's a stop sign with tumors or something, or it's a stop sign with bad acne. I don't know what you want to call it. It's a thing. And so anyway, they originally allocated this thing, the stop thing, to have seven miners for everyone to get maximum transmit scale, maximum reward, so on and so forth. Unfortunately, you can see now that there are three too many inside this zone. I have mine all the way down here alone, 350 meters apart from everyone else, and kind of in its own little, like another stop sign thing with tumors, if we were to break it down even further. But then you see everyone else up here. So that means they allocated seven. There's actually 10, and that's why we're seeing some transmit scale hit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, or maybe it's just saying seven. Is there something I'm missing here? No, because it said limit five interactive hotspots. There's three too many. So maybe in that there's eight, but there's seven, whatever. Then if we go to our other hotspot, which is kind of sitting over here, this one is saying that they want seven. There's five interactive hotspots available, and there's one more spot available, which is why we are currently sitting at a 1.0 transmit scale. Let me zoom into here. Can we get any smaller? No, we can't get any smaller than this little stop sign thingy here. So yeah, and we've got one here. So when people start populating this area, then our transmit scale on our other original Mac Daddy is going to go down as well. And this is kind of frustrating because, again, when we first started helium mining back in September, we were the only two out here, and now everything's populated around us. Now, I have said that this has been great. It's good to have this network growing around us because that's giving my miners more opportunities to witness transactions and then also be witnesses. We want to be witnessing we want to be witnessing beacons because that's where the money is. So yeah, it's great if we have a total of 11 witnesses or five witnesses within the past, you know, couple of days, but we want to be the ones witnessing other miners, which is why it's super crucial we have those solid setups. We want our miner, and it looks like right now they're not even doing it, and it could be just because of the network coming back, but we want our miners to witness each other because that's where the helium mining is going to be. So it is kind of frustrating that our miner right now is now sitting at a 0.63. it's a little positive and a little uplifting to see we went from 0.56 to 6.3, but I want to get back over 0.75. I want to get back up to like 1.0, especially with me being the only one in that neighborhood, in my own little hexagon here. Like, I'm the only one like right in my hexagon. They have three here, four here. I shouldn't be penalized because inside my hexagon, I am providing that coverage. But it's that zone on Hotspotty that we pull up. That's what's the deciding factor of, and it just sucks. I'm like down here all alone. And Hotspotty says they're all up here. So put them in a different one. But this is all, and again, this is also for the greater good, because as transmit scales are decreased, helium allocates a specific amount of helium to be rewarded out each month. If we were to put all these helium miners out there with a 1.0 transmit scale with full rewards and full benefits, that would be depleted. Not everyone would get a share of the pie. So they do these transmit scales to make sure everyone gets a share of the pie. So we want all those transactions to keep firing off and those beacons and challenges to keep firing off. Now, with that said, it's going to be a lot better. Now, the rewards still, with the transmit scale being a little bit lower, I could kind of look into how I still want to see if we could push ourselves to 10 helium in 30 days. But now I kind of know that as that number gets lower, if we're not necessarily at 10, I can do some maths in my head and say, well, if I was at at 1.0, I would be over 10 helium in a 30-day spread versus now I'm at maybe 6 or 7 helium in a 30-day spread because of my transmit scale. But we still have to reevaluate that goal. But also the helium that we could be potentially earning from all those hackers and scammers and stuff that POVC 11 is affecting and stopping will also be able to be added back into that allocation on a monthly basis and spread out to people that have their miners legitimately set up. So overall, you've seen the positives of helium mining, you've seen the negatives of helium mining, and there's still much more for me to be able to cover on both sides of the fence. Do I think this is still a good platform and project to get into? Absolutely, because as the coverage grows and as the reward allocation for mining is given out, there's also going to be opportunities to earn helium based on people that actually transact on the Internet of Things and they transact inside your hotspot zone. So if you're out at a city, let's say like you're in downtown Orlando or Atlanta, and you see those little scooters where you can go up with your phone and rent it and it pays right there, that's something that is going to be heavily featured on the Helium network and the Internet of Things. So if that transaction's done at your hotspot coverage, then you get those rewards. And so this is a very, very good project. And it's, again, these miners are like not even a dollar in power. Once you get them set up and going and you have ideal placement, it's borderline set it and forget it until something goes wrong. But just like if you go to your router or anything like that, if you're having issues and you reboot it and you unplug it, plug it back in, it's really all you need to do. Once you get it going, I still think it's a great project. Holding the coin, I think, is a great opportunity as I see that price doubling. And I do see it getting over three figures, so maybe $100, $150 token in the long run. So don't let this video necessarily dishearten you. If you are in a very, very heavily populated zone, you can either look at the opportunity of just placing your miner there. And remember, you get one free assertion when you get your miners in. So maybe you can place your miner there and see what your rewards are going to be. Or you can look at the opportunity of hosting, having someone host your miner and offering them a cut. So it's really kind of a wishy-washy. You can either be at home and next to your miner and get that transmit scale and the lower rewards because of your area, or you can pay someone 25% to 30% if they allow you to install an antenna on their house and you have to drive out there. And you know, if it's your grandparents, they don't know what they're doing. It's kind of a wishy-washy thing, so it's really the choice is yours. I'm personally going to be a little mixture of both. When my mile site comes in, I've spoken to one of my buddies up the road that's outside of that zone, so that way I can get max rewards on his, and I'm going to be offering him 25% of the profits of that mining, the miner, because we're also going to be installing an antenna externally at his house. Hopefully we can get that one to talk to ours as well. So anywho, that's going to do it for me today, guys. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to reach out to me on Telegram, Twitter, or Discord. Links for all that is in the description below. We hit 15,000 subscribers, so I really want to say thank you very much to each and every single one of you. It's truly amazing. Hopefully, we can hit 25,000 subscribers, where then we're probably going to do a meetup event in California. We'll come out with some t-shirts, where you can buy in the link below, and maybe do some giveaways on stuff like that, and hopefully have a couple of beers with some of you guys out there. Otherwise, like, comment, subscribe, turn on the bell notification, all that good stuff. I'm Oprius, and we'll see you guys next time.
Shut up, Copper.